Interesting. The Samsung Galaxy S6 might be the best budget phone you can buy. Let's find out. So in Is It Still Worth It, I look at all the high-end phones to see if they still deliver. And while the LG G4 and the Galaxy Alpha still delivered something good for the price, the Samsung Galaxy S6 might be the best budget phone you can buy. To start off, it's following the current design trend of phones and something Samsung stuck to ever since the Samsung Galaxy S6, meaning the glass back, including wireless charging. However, there is something amiss though with the Samsung Galaxy S6, and that is the micro SD slot, which Samsung rightfully got a lot of crap for, seeing how it did not only remove the removable battery, but also the micro SD. They had an explanation for it that made sense, saying that onboard memory is faster, which is true in numbers, but it still didn't please the consumer. But then they go ahead and only sell a 32GB version as the base version and not something like a 64GB. This one, however, is a 128GB version, and I got this for about 170 euros, which is the price around the new Xiaomi Redmi Note 5. And honestly, a lot of other budget phones out there. And let's just cut to the chase. The Samsung Galaxy S6 would walk circles around them in camera department and build quality and overall speed, apart from the weird seizure moments you can have with its camera. The Samsung Galaxy S6, while being released in April of 2015, still has specs that are good for today's standard. The phone is protected by Gorilla Glass 4, and it is, like I said, a 32GB version, a 62GB version, or like this one, 128GB of internal memory, with UFS 2.0 technology, which was a faster memory released on the Samsung Galaxy S6 for the first time. It has the Exynos 7 octa-core 7420 CPU that is a 64-bit 14nm octa-core based chip, and of course the faster LPDDR4 RAM, which was 3GB. You had a 16MP camera with a f1.9 aperture and a 28mm sensor size, with optical image stabilization, and of course you could record 4K video in 30 frames per second. And with the Samsung Galaxy S6, they also made the fingerprint scanner work properly, meaning no swiping your finger over it, but just holding it on top of it and it will unlock your phone. Also, I love myself some proper home button, and the Samsung Galaxy S6 has that proper home button feeling with a really nice tactile feedback. And the Samsung Galaxy S6 had a 5.1 inch 2K Super AMOLED display, meaning 577 pixels per inch. And it was a really compact phone, with it also being just 6.8 millimeters thick. But that thickness led to one problem, and while it had quick charging, it only had a small battery of 2550 mAh, which is tiny compared to some of today's standard. In real life, it showed, and it had a pretty bad screen on time. But that small thing, literally, doesn't take away from how the Samsung Galaxy S6 still holds its own when you consider the price. Sure, it's not as fast or as smooth as current high-end phones, but that is not what you should compare it to. You should compare it to phones like the Blue S1 or the Dodgy Mix, or other phones around that price. And then the Samsung Galaxy S6 performs better overall. Apart from the battery, that is. Pictures that come from this phone are still good and still sharp, and it has an acceptable dynamic range, and of course we have that punch that we are used to from Samsung. In low light again, it's not as good as the current phones, but still, it takes good pictures for its price. And of course the display is still amazing. It has a 2K resolution, which is basically standard today, and it has that punchy effect that we are used to from Samsung with their AMOLED displays. And there is even more great news. While we already have Android 7.0 on the Samsung Galaxy S6, we are going to get Android 8.0, which is covered by C-Tech Care, showing that the Samsung Galaxy S6, the S6 Edge and the S6 Edge Plus will also get this new Android update. So if you don't mind buying an older phone, which will be secondhand because you cannot purchase these anymore in a new state, meaning there is no warranty, the Samsung Galaxy S6 is really a phone that you should consider if you are on a budget. Yes, in return you don't have the bezel-less idea like you have today, but with a 5.1 inch display, does it really matter? But honestly, if you are looking for a budget phone, this is one that you should really consider. And yes, while buying a new phone you do get warranty and you do probably get that 18.9 ratio bezel-less idea, you are not going to get a display that looks this good. For a budget, the Samsung Galaxy S6 outperforms all of those budget phones when it comes to the display itself alone. The display on the Samsung Galaxy S6 with its 2K resolution and its great AMOLED display just is better than any budget phone out there. So what do you think about the Samsung Galaxy S6? Do you think it's still worth it? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, don't forget to like if you like this video and subscribe if you like my content. Have a good one and talk to you guys in the next.